The jump bind Xcode lets you navigate between the different files or different parts of files, or even in the history of your project or of the editing you've done in the last few minutes quickly. And let me show you how this works. So we are here in Xcode in the project I'm working on right now, and the jumper is the thing here above the editor window, or the editor. It's called editor in Xcode. And I can select here, for example, where I want to go in the file. I can select the file in the folder I'm currently working on, that I want to jump to. I can select the folder itself, and I can even select different kinds of the or different elements of the project I'm working on right now. And there's also at the beginning, four squares, and if you select those, you have different kinds of, it's a contextual menu that allows to navigate your code. For example, when I select a method, let's go somewhere where we have a custom method, the update method. And I want to see where this is called. Unfortunately, it doesn't work at the moment, but normally you have here the callers selected, or you can select the callers and can figure out what is going on. Let's try it somewhere else. No, the callers doesn't work. But usually you have a selection of all the callers that call this method. Doesn't work here, unfortunately. But what I use in this context menu is recent files. If I know I was at a recent file in the last few minutes, I can go here and select one of those recent files. I can open this window as well with Control Zero, no, Control One, and then navigate with the arrow keys. And there are other jump bar elements I can quickly switch to. For example, with Control Two, I go back in the history of my editing. So when I this is all the files I visited during my editing session, and I can go back there. And if I want to jump forward in the history, I select Control 3, and I can go forward in the history of my editing workflow. Then Control 4 lets me opens the jump bar for the project, and Control 5 the one for the folder I'm working on right now. And the most important one, Control 6, lets me quickly search or navigate to one part of this file. Let's switch to a file that's a bit bigger. For example, postcard. In no list, no postcards, view conditions. Do this again. Postcard additions view controller. This one, this is a bigger one. And when I select Control 6, it opens this file. And when I start typing while this is open, it filters out everything that matches using fuzzy search. So, for example, I can use table and then did select, and I find exactly what I'm searching for, and then I hit return and I'm on this file. I can go down and do some stuff here and edit some things here. And when I add marks in my file, for example, let's add a mark here. Mark, that's a comment, and it starts with mark colon, and then you can put in some text here. And this one is visible in this quick search or items list with some special decoration. For example, this dash here creates a line above this in the overview, in the list. And if I put a line at the end of it, I get another one. I get a line above and below this thing. Usually we just need one, because this what comes after this one belongs to iCloud sharing controller delegate, and this is now marked here in my overview. I also have a mark here for actions, so I can jump between those quickly. If you happen to use Minimap, you can see the same mark there in the Minimap that shows you where in your code are. So these marks are very helpful in the Minimap and in the quick jump while you are jumping around in this file. Yeah, this is the jump bar. I set up my keyboard that I have special keys for all those control 1, control 2, 3. No, 3 is not. Because I'm not. I have to have something to jump forward to in the history, that control 3 shows the forward history. And let's see the future of this editing history. And also control 4, control 5, and control 6. But I use control 5 and control 6 the most. And you can also jump between schemes when you have several schemes by using control 0, and you can select the scheme you want to run. This I usually don't use that, because in most of the projects I'm working on, I'm just having one scheme I have to execute. So this is not really important for my day-to-day work, but it's good to have it, to use it there. Yeah, this is all I wanted to show you about the jump bar. I use it quite a lot because I try to not use my keyboard, my trackpad to navigate as much as I can, and this helps a lot in connection with OpenQuickly. And this is one I will show you in another video, how to open quickly a file or something you want to work, or you know it is in your project and then want to jump to it without searching in the project navigator. This is everything for this video. I hope to see you next time. Until then, bye.